Bismillah, alhamdulillah, wa salatu wa salamu ala rasulillah. Dear friends, may Allah accept your siyam and qiyam. Our woman for today is Al-Khansa. Al-Khansa probably was the best of the poets, the Arabic poets, or the best of the women poets. Her name is Tumadur, which means Shadidatul Bayad, fair skin. And her title, Al-Khansa. And Al-Khansa means the lady where the bridge of the nose is too low. So it's called Al-Khansa. In the Jahiliyyah, she was a judge in Souq Aukaz. It's a gathering of massive fair for everything, not only merchandise, but also for poetry arbitration, who is the best and who is, and she would pinpoint the mistakes a poet has done. Even Hassan ibn Thabit was one of those she judged that he's not too good. In one of the lines. So she was very important lady, and she had two brothers. One is Muawiyah and the second is Sakhr. And one after another they were killed in those regional wars, tribal wars. This tribalism is too deep in the human psyche, and this is what gonna get rid of humanity on the planet Earth, because the brain and the technology and all of this is under the influence of the emotional brain, the reptilian brain. Nowadays we have nuclear bombs, so if that irrational or emotional brain push a button, it can blow up the planet Earth. So she would cry them so much. As a matter of fact, her poetry is mainly about eulogy. She would cry her first brother. Then when Sakhr was killed, she went berserk in crying him and making poetry. Most of her collection of poetry is about Sakhr. And there's no one of us who were raised in high schools and so on back home who would not memorize several of his lines, of her lines about Sakhr. Even I have read and I tried to find the strength of this. Anything comes from the mouth of Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, I like to check it out and make sure it's nothing weak or of the narration or the chain of command of chain of the narrators. He would see her and say, he khunas. He's enticing her to sit and read poetry to him. Wa yumi'u biyadihi ilayha. The whole thing's changed after Islam. When she accepted Islam and she stopped crying the people of the Jahiliyyah, and she was married and she had four children, men. They grew up very strong, very courageous. And they went to the battle of Al-Qadisiyah. And they were killed, all of them. And when the news came back to her, she didn't cry, she didn't make poetry, but she said, thank God for their martyrdom, and I hope I will meet them in heaven. What a change. So this is a part, or at least a little story about Al-Khansa. In Arabic, she said, Alhamdulillah alladhi sharrafani bistishhadihim wa arju min rabbi an yajma'ani bihim fi mustaqarri rahmatih. She died in Khilafat Uthman ibn Affan radiyallahu anhu in the year 24 of the Hijrah. May God bless you. Wassalamu alaikum wa rahmatullah.